If you really hate Kim Jong-un, the North Korean leader's massively over-the-top eating habits will probably make you dislike him even more. From imported cheeses and expensive liquors to fine wines and gourmet dinners, this is what Kim Jong-un loves to eat and drink. The golden rule with Kim's eating habits is that if he likes something, he gorges on it to an almost inhuman degree. Take Emmental cheese, for example. This hole-riddled Swiss cheese is best known for its sweet aroma, fruity flavor, and iconic appearance, as well as the complicated process by which it's made. Kim loves Emmental cheese, having likely picked up a taste for it during his school days in Switzerland. In fact, he likes it so much that he had to step out of the public eye in 2014 for health reasons, which, according to the South Korean newspaper Yonhap, was an affliction of gout. Yonhap went on to report that Kim's gout was thought to be brought on by his high-calorie diet, lack of exercise, and obsession with cheese. North Korea's government has even been known to send representatives across the world in order to better serve the state's cheese-producing infrastructure. In 2014, Pyongyang officials visited a French dairy college in an attempt to secure more fine cheeses for their country and their leader. Sadly, they were reportedly turned down. Oh well. Sushi has been a vital part of life in North Korea's upper echelon since long before Kim came to power. Kenji Fujimoto was Kim Jong-il's long-serving personal sushi chef, and says he was Kim Jong-un's friend and playmate during their childhood and teen years. He recalls the younger Kim having an affinity for sushi made with toro, the fatty part of the tuna, which is the same cut his father loved. Fujimoto told Mail Online, "I used to make sushi for the general at least once a week, and Jong-un always joined the dinner, so I could say Jong-un likes sushi." Fujimoto had arrived in North Korea in 1982, on a one-year contract to teach sushi making to Pyongyang chefs. He then agreed to stay on for longer, quickly becoming a close confidant to Kim Jong-il. After a few run-ins with Japanese intelligence agencies, however, Fujimoto eventually fled the country. When Kim Jong-un took the country's reins in 2012, however, Fujimoto was invited back for a visit, which would imply some kind of genuine goodwill towards his father's former sushi chef. Either that, or he really liked his sushi. In a 2013 interview with GQ, Fujimoto announced his intentions to return to North Korea for good, and in 2017, he opened a sushi restaurant in Pyongyang. In 2015, shortly before his return to North Korea, Kenji Fujimoto spoke to the Daily Mail about his future leader's eating habits. Recalling his 2012 visit to the country, Fujimoto explained that he had attended a boozy, extravagant banquet at which Kim Jong-un was present, giving some insight into the kinds of delicacies Kim prefers. Among other things, shark fin soup was on the menu. Fujimoto explained, "I poked a dish of shark fin a couple of times to gesture I was enjoying it, but I was very tense and could not eat much. Shark fin soup is an East Asian delicacy and one of the most controversial dishes in the world, largely because its popularity has pushed some species of shark to the edge of extinction." The chef revealed he had also eaten Kobe steak during the banquet too, and one of the priciest varieties of beef on the planet. To qualify as Kobe, the beef must meet a strenuous list of different criteria, based on location, quality of meat, and weight restrictions. It tends to cost around $150 per pound. It's not just high-quality food that Kim enjoys gorging on. Import data released in 2017 revealed that in 2016, North Korea had imported just over $900,000 worth of Brazilian coffee into the country for its leader and his entourage. And that figure was almost 12 times greater than that reported in 2015.
"You know, this is, excuse me, a damn fine cup of coffee."
Brazil is generally regarded as being home to some of the finest coffee in the world. Today, the country is the single largest exporter of coffee, with most of its stock shipping to Germany, the United States, Italy, Japan, and Belgium. Brazil's rich soil and hot climate make it an ideal environment in which to grow coffee, with some of the country's finest coffees coming from its southern regions. It's not known exactly which brand of coffee Kim likes to import, but some of Brazil's more expensive coffees tend to run up to $50 per pound. Other brands can cost as much as $500 per pound. Whatever Kim is drinking, though, one thing is clear: he's drinking a heck of a lot of it. Kim Jong-un is no stranger to a drink or two. In fact, he regularly imports more alcohol for his own personal use than most people will ever drink in their lives. In 2019, for example, the Dutch port of Rotterdam seized 90,000 bottles of Russian vodka, which officials believed were headed to Pyongyang. A ship belonging to a Chinese company called Costco Shipping was halted in Rotterdam on a tip from the Russian Foreign Ministry, and customs agents discovered some 3,000 cases of vodka inside. The United Nations have previously banned the export of luxury goods to North Korea, but over the previous 2 years, the country had attempted to dodge international sanctions. Allegedly, the vodka was supposed to be enjoyed by Kim and his military commanders. And although the shipment didn't quite make it to Pyongyang, it's likely that many more reached the shores of North Korea on a regular basis. Not just the bubbly of choice for French connoisseurs, movie stars, and yacht enthusiasts, champagne is also a favorite among planet Earth's worst despots. Kim Jong-un, of course, is no exception. During his sit-down with the Daily Mail, Kenji Fujimoto revealed that Kim's love of fancy booze has probably contributed to his ever-expanding waistline. Fujimoto told the website, "He drank a lot. His favorite was Cristal, usually about 2 bottles in a sitting." Produced by the Louis Roederer estate, Cristal was created in 1876, at the behest of Tsar Alexander II of Russia. Described by the estate as a remarkably balanced and refined champagne, Cristal is known for its silky texture and fruity aromas. Perhaps more importantly, however, it is also ludicrously expensive. Bottles regularly sell for well over $100, with some larger formats going for upwards of $11,000. Considering the name Cristal is practically synonymous with a lavish, extravagant lifestyle, it's not surprising that Kim enjoys it so much. Under Kim Jong-il, North Korea allegedly spent around $1 million every year on Hennessy, a brand of French cognac which costs about $630 per bottle in North Korea. For what it's worth, that's more than most North Koreans make in a year. Kim the Elder had often been spotted drinking Hennessy at meetings and summits with world leaders, and it's very likely that the apple hasn't fallen far from the tree. At the very least, it's not hard to imagine there's still a little of Kim Jong-il's Hennessy stash left lying around. Hennessy is one of the world's finest and largest cognac producers. Established in 1765, the estate's product has been enjoyed by such historical figures as King George IV and Tsar Alexander I, and has been drunk all across the world. Exactly how much Hennessy Kim consumes on a daily basis is unclear, but the amount the country spends on importing it would imply they bring in thousands of bottles every year. Even accounting for his military attaché, his entourage, and his personal friends, that's a whole lot of cognac. According to Kenji Fujimoto, Kim has a particular penchant for French wine, and once boasted about drinking 10 bottles of Bordeaux in a single night. Although this claim did come from a man who insists he started driving at the age of 3, so you can probably take it with a grain of salt. Considering Bordeaux could mean any number of different wines, it's hard to gauge how much money this would cost. A bottle of Bordeaux could easily sell for no more than a few dollars. Equally, however, it could also fetch thousands of dollars. It just depends on which wine estate produced it, and when. But let's face it, Kim probably didn't go for the cheap stuff. As for the 10 bottles in one sitting claim, well, a bottle of red wine tends to contain around 5 glasses, meaning on that fateful night, Kim would have had drunk around 50 standard-sized drinks. For what it's worth, drinking only 5 glasses every week can knock years off your life. The exact health effects on a human who manages to drink 50 glasses of wine in one go aren't particularly well known, however, largely because it'd be basically impossible to do that without passing out. According to a 2014 report by UK tabloid Metro, Kim regularly drinks snake wine, a popular drink that includes a dead cobra in the bottle, which is thought by some to increase the virility of the drinker. Kim's reliance on snake wine is said to have come from his desire and failure to father a second child with his wife. In the report, a South Korean expat explained, "The elite in the country joke that he is too big to please his wife, and that's why they do not have any other children." One senior official said that Kim was drinking many bottles of snake wine to help him in the bedroom department. Snake wine is popular all across South China and Southeast Asia. Its makers usually put one large snake inside each bottle and throw in a number of different roots, berries, and herbs for flavor or medicinal effect. The flavor is said to be earthy and similar to rice wine with a protein finish, like a fishy chicken. Occasionally, the snake is drowned in the alcohol during the winemaking process, leading to the occasional incident in which half-living snakes have leapt out of the bottle and attacked the drinker.
Snakes. Why did it have to be snakes?
As a state leader, Kim often finds himself attending lavish dinners, banquets, and other similar events. Unsurprisingly, the menus at such events tend to be chock-full of hot cuisine and gourmet dishes. Take Kim's Hanoi summit with Donald Trump in February 2019, for example. The menu was originally set to include Hanoi-style spring rolls, grilled cod chaka, and shredded mango salad with scallops. On that particular occasion, the menu actually became subjected to something of a last-minute rewrite. In the end, Kim was served shrimp cocktail with Thousand Island dressing, grilled sirloin with pear kimchi, and chocolate lava cake with fresh berries and vanilla ice cream for dessert. The exact reason for the change in menu wasn't given, but it's probably no coincidence that those foods are the exact type of thing you tend to find on the menu at Trump's own hotels and restaurants. Kim attended another dinner in 2018, this time with South Korean President Moon Jae-in. In the peace house that stands in the Korean Demilitarized Zone's so-called Truce Village of Panmunjom, Kim and Moon dined on a number of extravagant dishes. This included chilled octopus garnished with citrus soy sauce, Korean beef with vegetables, and parcels of sea cucumber, cod, and beef. The dinner was also rife with symbolism, with ingredients sourced from locations with personal value to the two leaders, surprise miniature maps of a unified Korea, and frequent acknowledgments of both countries' culinary traditions. Did it work? Well,
the North Korean leader Kim Jong-un says the world will soon get a glimpse of what he called a new strategic weapon.
Of course, though tensions between North and South Korea tend to run high, often risking the deaths of tens of thousands of people, the citizens of each country can rest assured their leaders are eating like kings. Not that that's necessarily comforting. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more MASH videos about the world's finest foods are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.